Welcome to Bethel Christian Academy's 50th year. Our 50th year theme is found in this first yearbook from 1970-71, and that is from 1 Corinthians chapter 10, verse 31, all for the glory of God. So what was it like 50 years ago on that first day of school? Marvin Deaver was there. He can tell us what was happening and what God was doing in the hearts of Pastor David Paramore and in the hearts of the people of Bethel Free Will Baptist Church. Marvin Deaver was the secretary and business manager before the first day of school.
The excitement in those earlier years was so great, and you know, and the things that were going on at Bethel, people being saved, and then the idea of building a Christian school, and that meant we had to build buildings. I remember that the church owed about $125,000, and what we were fixing to go into was going to be an increase in our obligations. The early stages, we were only going to go like with the first three, four grades. So many people in the church had kids that had already gone through those grades in the public school system. So there was so much pressure, you might say, from the church people to include my kid. And so that we decided to go to grade 10. And we didn't know what we were getting ourselves into. We didn't know exactly the problems. We were all new. Then we had to consider building a high school building, another $150,000. So we were going to end up with a $300,000 bond program to support this. So we got the teachers, and then we realized we had no principal. So we needed someone to take this project and carry this school forward. Minister of Music, Doug Henderson, was here and doing his job and doing his responsibilities, came with us that first year. They hired me as business manager, and I also took care of the transportation. I set up all the routes, hired the student drivers to support those routes. And I believe that first year we had somewhere in the neighborhood of 500 kids that came that year. Here we are, all new, you know, everybody learning from each other. And we had 500 kids that was on this campus. We were not all associated with Bethel. We had outsiders that came in and helped us, but we were so glad that they did and they worked with us to help develop what is now, that we can be happy that we did.
Amazing faith, commitment, and hard work, the Academy began its first day that fall of 1970. Kenny and Teresa Sutton were students on that first day.
I met my wife here her first day of school. We were just friends all through school. And now I'm currently school board chairman and the baseball coach here. So I enjoy doing it and staying close with the guys. I remember our first year here, some things new when you come to a new school, stuff that sticks out in your mind. It's been 50 years ago, but I remember the smell of new carpet, new construction, paint on the walls. Air conditioning. We didn't have air conditioning in public schools. I thought this was it, you know. First year I got to play on the basketball team. We only went through the 10th grade, so I was in the 8th grade. We had never been in a gym till our first game. And we got our uniforms that day. I remember going in and just looking in the gymnasium, you know, as a high school team, and I'm in the 8th grade, just a little guy, you know. We're sitting there and we're thinking, man, this would be nice, you know. The score of the game when we scored our first point, we were down 24-0, and one of our guys come up and just threw up a shot and hit the backboard and went in, and we all erupted off the bench. You would have thought we had won the game.
I'm Teresa Taylor Sutton. I graduated in 1975, and I was here the first day of school. It was a very nice environment, and I felt safe and secure. My parents had planned to send me to a different private school, and the week before school started, they came and talked to Doug Henderson, the principal, and after talking with him, they just changed their mind. They just felt like this would be a better place for me, and I'm so thankful that they did. I met my husband, Kenny, here, and glad that my children could come and graduate from here.
David and Eliza Baker met at Bethel Christian Academy that first year and shares their memories.
My name is Eliza Oglesby Baker, and this is my husband, David Baker. I was a teacher assistant for 30 years in the Lenoir County school system. We started going to this school when it opened in 1970, and we were freshmen. And I met the love of my earthly life here at school at Bethel. We started dating when we were at the end of our junior year. We have two sons, Will and Josh. Oldest son, Will, decided he'd like to go to Bethel. He met his wife here, and their children, of course, are going there now. When I look back, I can't begin to name all the great teachers that we had. I'll name some that just come to mind for me, and that was my first homeroom teacher was Miss Mazingo, and she taught French and Bible. Miss Murphy, I remember Mr. Tippett, I remember Miss Malone, it's Kay Davis, and she taught me the math and the algebra and the geometry. She was a tough teacher, but she was very good. Really kind of got a love for math and all in her class. I enjoyed it very much.
Greg Fordham has worn many hats at BCA. A student, teacher, parent, business manager, and now a grandparent.
I'm currently the business manager of the school, following up on the leadership of Brother Deaver, and have been associated with the school for these 50 years. As a student for a while, graduated in 1974, came back in the early 80s and actually taught for 5 years. Met my wife through one of my students. He was in her family, and he introduced us, and she caught me, so we are married now and have been. Was a parent in the 90s when my kids were here. They graduated in 2002 and 2006, and so now being in employment here as the business manager, still involved, it's a little bit different perspective, because I've seen it from the student standpoint, the teacher standpoint, and the parent standpoint, as well as now the employment standpoint. So it gives quite a variety of ways to look at things. I think I can relate to the parents or the kids, or the faculty even, with some of the problems they have, because I've been in all those places. But it has been a real joy to be involved. I feel like next to Christ, of course, and the church, this school is probably the most important thing that I've done with my life, and hope to continue for many more years to be able to be a part of all that. Been able to watch through the years students come in that were not part of us, but they did adapt, they did learn, and they did become saved as a result of the school. There are countless people in our church today that would not be a part of the church if the kids hadn't come through school and they got involved in the church. I think some of the spiritual highlights were starting a school. It's a whole different setting, because like Kenny and Teresa, I'd been in public school for 8 years. But when we came here, classes start with prayer, chapel services every week. It's a Christian influence and a Bible class every single day. That was different from what we were used to, but it helped us spiritually. It helped us to grow. And I think that spiritual impact has been so great. Obviously, the biggest outreach that our church has over the years. It's the most expensive outreach, a lot going on. Sacrifice early on. If you were on the deacon board in those early years, you were asked more than once to go down to the bank and sign a note, because we had to have money to operate. And Brother Deaver did a great job coordinating all that. And Brother Paramore was very involved in those things. You know, now I'm not sure board members would be willing to do that kind of thing, to go sign a note so that we can make the payroll or we can pay our bills. You know, we have to be solvent. We have our testimony to keep up. And the Lord has really blessed us, and it's just exciting to be a part of it, and I'm more excited about things that are to come.
Once founded in 1970, the Academy went forward to establish itself as an outstanding Christian Academy. In 1985, Dr. Eddie Moody graduated from the Academy. Dr. Moody, who was the Associate Dean at North Carolina Central University and is now the Executive Director of the National Association of Free Will Baptists, speaks about his years as a student.
As I think about Bethel, I'm reminded of so many of my teachers, such a good job they did preparing us academically. And I remember we had a diverse group of teachers when it comes to like their academic training. And they all wanted us to do what we could to the glory of God. They all wanted us to strive for excellence and to do very well. I really enjoyed the athletics. That's one thing that was that we had at Bethel that other schools didn't have. A bigger school, you wouldn't have had the opportunity to participate in. Chapel, I remember we had the regular preaching. It would sometimes be teachers, sometimes even the principal. And then there would also be times where people would give testimonies. And so I would hear from the upperclassmen how they were talking about some of the challenges they were experiencing spiritually. And I can even think about my own life, where things started down the road I'm on today, and it all happened there at Bethel.
13 years later, 1998, Dr. Will Baker, MD, son of David and Eliza Baker, whom we heard from earlier, graduated from BCA along with his wife, Rebecca.
I'm Will Baker. I was in the class of 1998. I started BCA in eighth grade. This is my wife, Rebecca Baker. We met here at Bethel Christian Academy. She started in K-4 and also graduated in the class of 1998. Went to NC State and did electrical engineering and then went to medical school, and I'm a private practice family physician here in town. Both of our children are now attending the academy, a fifth grader and a second grader. One of my best memories of the school was just the small class sizes we had and the really tight-knit group.
The one thing that I took away the most from BCA was one of my favorite teachers. She was my piano teacher. She taught me choir, Miss Varner. She's just one person that made everything great while I was here.
One of the reasons why I came to school here was both of my parents attended here, really got a good education and a good spiritual background. Even after myself coming here and graduating here, me and my wife decided to send our children here, and you know, we're now on our third generation here at Bethel Christian Academy.
The academy grew during the years and even survived Y2K. Then Adam Fowler, North Carolina State Trooper, graduated in 2001.
I am currently a state trooper with the North Carolina Highway Patrol. I've been in law enforcement for about 16 years now. I am married to Tony Fowler. Tony is also a graduate of Bethel. We actually met here and became high school sweethearts and have been together ever since. Also, I'm a parent of students here as well, so not only am I a graduate, I'm a parent now. I have a son that's in the fourth grade, Ryan, and a daughter, Casey, that's in the second grade. So yeah, so now I'm both a graduate and a parent as well. As being a student, you don't understand why you're being made to do things and go to school, and now that I'm a parent, I'm the one giving the orders and fussing at them to get in there and do their homework. It was like a lot of young people in that age group. I was trying to find my way and trying to fit in. And, you know, it was almost a little tough to start with. I was at a point in my life I could have gone in a different direction. I can honestly say if it hadn't been for the staff, the teachers and the people that were here working, that instead of being in the line of work today I'm in putting handcuffs on somebody, if it hadn't been for those people that cared, I might be the one having handcuffs put on me today. You can only do so much in the home and church and being in a Christian environment because they're in school most of the time. They're in school more than they're with me really during the week, more than they're in church during the week. So we want to optimize the time that our children were able to learn about God and be in a godly environment, a Christian environment.
As we fast forward through the years, we come to the 42nd year of the Academy with a 2012 graduate, Courtney Stroud, who is now a CPA. She describes the best years of her life at BCA.
Hey y'all, my name is Courtney Stroud and I'm a graduate of the class of 2012. I can't believe it's been almost 7 years since I stepped foot out of these halls as a student of BCA. After graduation, I went on to NC State, go Pack, to pursue a degree in accounting thanks to Mr. Potter's accounting course my senior year. You gotta love a good old assets equals liabilities and equity. I graduated from NC State in May 2016 with my Bachelor's of Science in Accounting with concentration in financial analysis. After graduation, I started studying for the CPA exam and went on to work full-time as a tax associate at Johnson Lambert in Raleigh, North Carolina, where I currently still work today. In August 2018, I was able to add some initials behind my name as I finally received my CPA license. And in May 2020, I get to add some initials to the front of my name as I get to marry my high school sweetheart. Any school can teach you the basic course curriculum, but what Bethel teaches is so much more. Bethel taught me values. I didn't understand this as a student, but now as a young adult, I am forever grateful for the sacrifices my parents made for me and my brother Cody to attend Bethel. I attended Bethel from kindergarten to my senior year, so going to NC State was a bit of an adjustment as Bethel was the only school I had ever known. Playing volleyball, basketball, and soccer, and singing in the choir, doing fine arts competitions, we kind of did it all. Those were the best years of my life, and I tell everybody to this day that I'd do anything to go back to high school. I could go on and on about all the great things that Bethel has to offer. It was a phenomenal school. It may not have all the opportunities that a public school has to offer, but you get what you need and you get it in a safe, clean, and respectful environment. I was lucky enough to be the valedictorian of the class of 2012, and I was valedictorian at NC State as well. That goes to show you that anything's possible if you just work hard and put forth the effort. I'm so honored to be an alumna of Bethel Christian Academy and to have been able to share a little bit of my story with you today.
Jonathan Truitt, who is currently attending Welch College and Vanderbilt University's ROTC program, is training to be an Army chaplain. Let's hear from Jonathan.
Hi, my name is Jonathan Truitt. I'm a 2017 graduate of BCA. High school retreat was definitely the spiritual highlight in my life. Hearing from Brother Jeff Jones and Brother Jake Manning and Brother Ron Davis, hearing from such men of God and role models in my life, just to start off the school year in a way to honor and glorify God, that was definitely the spiritual highlight. My most valuable memory at Bethel was probably winning 2 state championships in my senior year. We won football state championship on our first season and then winning baseball championship. So looking back on my times at Bethel, I wouldn't trade them for anything in the world. This place means so much more to me than a school or a church. It's where I grew up. It's all that I've ever known, and I wouldn't trade it for anything in the world.
Thank you, Jonathan. Once a Trojan, always a Trojan. Over 1,000 students have graduated from Bethel Christian Academy during the last 50 years. We have only heard from 8 of them in this video, but there are many others who are living a life all for the glory of God. If you would like for your family to be a part of the Bethel Christian Academy family, please visit our webpage. You will find everything there you need to begin the enrollment process. Another way for you to be a part of BCA is by giving $50 to Bethel Christian Academy's 50th anniversary annual fund. You can donate directly on the webpage. We would appreciate your prayers and your support. Thank you for your interest in what God has done, what God is doing, and what God will do in the future for Bethel Christian Academy. Carry on for Christ.
I like this school.
We like you too, man. We love you.
Yeah, buddy. Yeah.